While we're waiting for Anne, I'll just tell you a bit about my past with Jim. Jim and I met long ago in the 1960s on two fronts. We were very much involved in the war, opposing American war in Vietnam. And I left USA as a draft dodger and arrived in this country. And that's where Jim and I first met, opposing the war in Vietnam, the American war in Vietnam. And also then we pretty quickly teamed up on battling against homelessness. And we were involved very much in many homelessness campaigns. You can see now, opening next week at Morley College, an exhibition of the work of Jim Radford and other people, the Black Forest Settlement in the 1970s in SE1. And of course, Joanna and Steve, they live there upstairs in the Black Forest Settlement. So we're very much involved in that, involved in the organizing. And Jim's wife, Jenny, she's the one who thought of the practicalities that nobody else thought of. What are you going to eat when you occupy a center point and you're up there trapped and the police have surrounded you and locked you in? So Jenny thought about, you know, there must be food. Okay. I couldn't go in because I had my new baby joining in my arms, so I was outside. So that's where Jim and I go back to that time. But I wasn't singing back then with Jim. I was into the blues and jazz and all, and Jim later got me into folk singing. You can see over here an article from Folk London, which I wrote. It's on the board. You can see also an issue of the SE1 Black Furs, in which Steve also was involved in setting up with photographs. And you can see that exhibition now opening at Morley College Gallery. And it has a lot of stuff on Jim and his activities battling against homelessness. And so later on, Jim got me into the book. So.
Okay, welcome back to part two. And this is Jim's other life in the Jolly Farmers at Lewisham. He used to spend a lot of time at Folkmore, but most of the musicians are from Folkmore. This is his other life.
He was cheating on you the whole time.
See? The Jolly Farmers on Monday night. There he was. Okay. Tonight they are Jim's Jolly Jammers. Here they are. Big hand.
Thank you.
you very much. So these are songs that we were rehearsing on the night before lockdown, the 16th of March, wasn't it? We were rehearsing for our Paddy Knight concert. And we got a call from Mick saying it's off. So these are songs that Joe and I sang together, that song and this next song, Roseville Fair.
Sing a little more.
do the fiddle and the banjo, just the way we did at the Roseville Fair. Jones, I want to introduce to you Anne McNeil. Mella Banerjee. Jacqueline Frank. Who's just got back in time from Jamaica. She's filming us. And Baz Bowen. Chicago. I'm Nick Jeffrey from Oklahoma. Where you go to the country. Jim's Jolly Jammers string band had worked very hard composing a medley of Jim's songs, and I'm really looking forward to it. We're doing Down by the Riverside, an anti-war song. We did many of these, and we sang at many events. And we sang also at many events up to lockdown for Black Lives Matter rallies from the very beginning of those in this country, Jim and I. But many, many people have carried on Jim's songs for the CMD, even since last summer. We've been doing stuff for the CMD on Zoom with Ellen over here, Paul, who's going to sing, and the Gillies, who couldn't be here tonight, that's Susan and Mark, and we've been carrying these events on now, even when we keep doing it. Oh, bring me down. My walking cane, bring me down, my walking cane. Oh, bring me down, my walking cane. I'm gonna leave on the midnight train. Ain't to study war no more. Well, I ain't gonna study war. Ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study. Thank you. step back from the microphone.
Thank you.
demonstration of Jim's jolly Germans. You see, you didn't know Jim produced an orchestra.
If there's a war, don't you go? to the court is right, well, let them be the ones to fight. We wonder who the enemy are, someone near or someone far, except the men who want to rule the kids we voted for at school. Which makes me ask the reason why, why they send us out to die. They say the weakness grown in men is greed of the power to command.
Without playing. So we squeezed him in, and that was worth it, wasn't it? Cracking guitar player. Paul
Stewart.
Welcome back again, Pittsburgh. Absolutely on the money. Pittsburgh, I remind you.
Asking Sue Ford over there, because years and years and years and years and years ago I met somebody at Woolwich and he said, let's start a folk club. He started it and I used to go along with me, and after a couple of hours in the Crown of Cushion, which has now been demolished, but that was many years ago. And I was saying to Sue, because Sue, that's where I met Sue and Mike over there, and then we said, well, yeah, when did we meet Jim? And it appears that was about 28 years ago, was it?
Yes. Yeah,
yeah, in the Rising Sun in Elton High Street, when we did a Sunday night session.
I think there was a lot of drinking.
And I still don't know this.
I can't quite remember exactly.
I'm the one who couldn't learn words.
Not that there is any correlation between folk music and drinking at all.
Not at all.
I do have to say the rugby club now is quite, the rugby players don't drink as much as they used to.
They're quite sober, actually.
They are quite sober.
All that folk lot next door.
They are, yes. Anyway, this is a song that Dave still wants to have words for, and it must have been played 52 weeks of the year for 28 years, and he still needs the words. And Jim used to play the Boron on this one at certain times. Okay, so who's going to guess what the song is? Oh no! guys on. Sing along. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Dave's got to have them. Have you turned the volume up?
Yeah, the volume's up. Right, doesn't matter, I'll use it
better. I don't know what it is for Dave and his guitars, they never switch tone on. Have you got the tune wrong?
He's got to buy a new battery.
9-volt battery.
We have this quite a lot.
Right. Can I use your lead? Give me your lead. Wait a minute.
This is maybe my
We're going to see if it's this or not. Yeah, it's not. Right. And then I'll just do it without it. Oh, gosh, that was loud, wasn't it? That one. Are you on? Are you off now?
I must be this lead then.
I don't mind being louder than you.
Somebody turned the DI box off.
Because I always get the blame, you see. Everyone says, oh, it's always his fault because his battery's dead or something. We've got a duff guitar.
Okay, it wasn't your fault.
Right, it's a song that we used to do all the time, and I've done it for years, and I still can't remember the two verses. But Jim used to play along.
It's alright, Dave, everybody else.
On the boron. And the spoons, because we all, we love forums as well. We all actually love forums. Ready?
Okay, we'll just get that one.
could never go with you, no matter if I want to.
Because it's the last song that I sang with Jim, albeit on Zoom. And it just so happened that Roger took a video of it that night, and he's singing along with every word, so think of it quite fondly. As I went a-walking one morning in May, I spied a young couple did stray, and one was a young maid, so sweet and so fair, and the other was a soldier and a brave grenadier, and they kissed so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went on the nightingale sing, and they kiss so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went on and on along the road like sister and brother. They went on and on along the road till they came to a stream, and they sat down together, love, to hear the nightingale. old soldier, won't you marry me? Oh no, cried the soldier, however can that be? For I have my wife at home in my own country, and she is the sweetest little thing that you ever did see. And they kissed so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went arm in arm along the road like sister and brother. They went arm in arm along the road till they came to a stream. And they both sat down together, love, to hear the nightingales sing. Now I'm off to India for 7 long years, drinking wine and strong whiskey instead of cool beers. And when I return again, it'll be in the spring, and we'll both sit down together, love, to hear the nightingale sing. And they kiss so sweet and comforting as they clung to each other. They went arm in arm along the road like sister and brother.
I'm going to do Hard Times, although Jim would probably sniff at it a bit as an American parlour song, but it's, you know, I think he enjoyed it in the sort of joining in folk club sort of way as I do. And sadly, Hard Times are still with us, and as Jim said, if they put their heads together to sort out world hunger and so on, we wouldn't be having these hard times. Let us pause in life's pleasures and count our many tears. Oh, we all share in sorrow with the poor. It's a song that will linger forever in our ears. Oh, hard times come again no more. It's a song, the sigh of the weary. Hard times come again no more. Many days you have lingered too long around my door. Oh, hard times come again no more. Oh, we seek love and beauty and music bright and gay. There are pale forms fading out the door, though their voices are silent, their pleading faces say, oh, hard times come again no more. It's a song, the sigh of the weary. Many days you have lived. life away with a worn heart whose better days are o'er. Though her voice would be singing, 'tis sighing all the day. Oh, hard times come again no more. It's a song, the sigh of the weary. Hard times come again no more. Many days you have lingered too long around my door.
Oh, she was good tonight.
No.